So hey guys, welcome to this video solution of Code Forces Global Round 8 Problem D AND OR and Sum Square. We would be discussing this problem with great depth, covering all the cases, and finally I will be explaining the code which was accepted by the judge. So now the problem is here. You can read the problem, but if we try to understand the problem clearly without missing any important details, then the problem is just around one operation which we can perform any number of time, and that operation is that we are given an array. We can choose any two elements. So here it's given, let's say the first element we choose was AI and AJ, and the important point is that these two has to be distinct. And in one operation we can do something like this. We can replace AI with X and Y and AJ with X or Y. So basically these are the operations, then this is how we can modify the given array, and in the end we have to output the maximum sum of square which we can generate by doing these operations. So now let's get to the solution of this video for this question. So first we will discuss there was no edge case in the problem. Then if we go for the steps, this problem was I think mostly greedy, and with the main aim of this problem was to find the optimal substructure. If we were able to observe the optimal substructure, then we would definitely be able to solve this. And then how should we observe this problem? So we should observe each operations in depth. So now let's get started with the operations. So basically the operation is something like this. Suppose A and B are two elements of the array and we perform an operation in them. Then after the operation, so let's A would become A and B, and B would become A or B. So this was the operation. Now let's see in the bitwise representation that what exactly is happening. So we will consider all the cases like A, B, and then final A and final B. These are this and this. Okay. So what we would be doing is that we would be this considering this AND operation here and this OR operation here. So we would be storing the result of AND here and OR here. We can do it anyways, but the final answer would remain same. So let's see zero, all the possibility could be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So now if A and B both are 0, then if we do any of these operation, the answer would always be 0. So basically we need to stop and observe here also. This basically means that if we do AND and ON observe or AND and ON OR operation on A and B bit which are both 0, then there is no change. And at the same time, suppose we do this AND and ON this 0 and 1, this will become 0, this would be 1. So basically here also we need to have an observation that when we perform an AND operation on these two, then the one which is not present here is not hampered. That means the configuration remains same. So AND operation and ON OR operation gives the same answer, that B is 1 and A is 1, 0. Now the main part come here when the 1 and 0 are changed. Here if we see 1 and 0 is 0, but 1 or 0 is 1. So here is the really important thing happening. What is happening is that these are getting flipped. If we see that, so in final A the 1 is becoming 0, and in final B the B which was initially 0 is becoming 1. So this is the main operation, and in the last operation both of them would remain 1, because 1 and 1 is 1, 1 and 1 is 1. So basically this is here we should observe is that if both of the bits are 1, then there is no benefit of applying this operation. Okay, so now let's take an example which was in the contest. 135, the bitwise representation was 001, and here it was 011, here it was 101. So now let's see how should we think of performing these operations so that the value of sum of square of the output is maximum. Okay, so basically we will just mainly focusing on this operation first, that what is the benefit of performing this flip. Or rather than that, if we also observe in this, there is one more observation that the number of set bits is not lost. This is a really important point, that if we see that there are no set bit, then the output is also having no set bit, and if there are only one set bit, then the output also have only one set bit, and if here also is one and one, there are two set bits, there are two, so the number of set bits are always preserved. So we don't have to worry that after operation the value of our answer could decrease. It would remain same or it could increase. How it would be increasing, we would be discussing now. So now let's see how can we increase this value. So basically let's just focus on these 3 and 5 first. So these 3 is 0, 1, 1 and 5 is 1, 0, 1. Okay, so now let's see what is the output of the AND operation in these two. So 1, 1 would give 1, 1, 0 would give 0 and 0. And what is the output of OR operation? OR operation would give us 1, 1, 1. So basically if we now judge these position wise, so these, see the first position both of them has 1. The output also have 1. In the second position, one of them has 1 and other has 0. So the output of the OR has 1. And in this case, the 1 has 0 and 1 is 1, and still the output is 1. So basically the observation here is, if there is one set bit out of two corresponding which on which we are performing the operation, then the OR operation will always take the set bits and the unset bit would be given in the AND operation. And here also, this observation that the number of set bit is not lost is also valid. So if you see, the number of set bit are 4 here in the output, and in the input also it's 4. But the main thing is that we are clubbing them together. So now let's see, is this beneficial? Because of the output, after the output this became 7, this became 1. So now let's see how is it beneficial. So basically if you see here, 3 in the decimal representation is 2 to the power 1 plus 2 to the power 0. And 5 here is 2 to the power 2 plus 2 to the power 0. And here which we are getting, 1 is 2 to the power 0 and 7 is 2 to the power 2 plus 2 to the power 1 plus 2 to the power 0. So what this basically means is that we are just clubbing this into a bigger term. So like if we all know that a square plus b square is less than a plus b whole square. This is a really true trivial identity. As a square plus a plus b whole square is a square plus b square plus 2ab. So rather than individually squaring each of them and then adding, if we club as many as a plus b together, then this term over here would definitely increase the sum. So by performing this operation, we are just doing this. We are increasing this number of a, b and adding c. So from there here, 2 to the power 0, it, here it was 2 to the power 1, it came here, so here the 1 term is increased. So when we do 7 square, it would have 3 terms. Here it was less. Now exactly if we see, the answer here was 9 plus 25, which was I think 34, right. Here it was 49 plus 1, which was 50. So basically after all this discussion, what we found that after the operations, the number of set bits are not hampered, and we can just combine this 1 into this 0 to form a bigger number over here, such that the contribution of this number in the final answer is greater. So now basically let's see, let's have any example. So suppose this was the given input, and now if we want to maximize the final sum of square, then what could be our optimal approach? So basically the operation allow us to club any 1 and 0 together, 1 and 0 together, 1 and 0 together. Okay, so basically what I think we can able to transfer this into something like this. So 1 is already here, 1 is already here. We can bring this down by taking these two values and adding an OR operator between these two and storing here, an AND operator and storing it here. What will that make this as 1? This would become already 1. This would become 1 or 0, 1. And for this, 1 and 0, 0, 1 and 0, 0, 1 and 0, 0, 0 and 0. So after this operation, if you see that all these 1s are transferred here. So this numbers have more number of values. So initially there was 2 to the power 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 2 to the power 3 plus 2 to the power 1 in this value, and here it was 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 2 plus 2 to the power 0. But now if we see, we have 2 to the power 4 plus 2 to the power 3 plus 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 1 plus 2 to the power 0. And if we square these all and if we square these all and add separately, this would be definitely better. So the main point is that club as many ones below, and this can be done using the OR and AND operation. And then if we see the last value which is still remaining, we cannot add more ones here because all these are already ones, so we have to add this to the answer separately. So now let's walk through the code and we will be having more clarity. So here is the code. So here we are getting the input of the array, and here we are storing the bitwise. So we need to match this code to our idea, and the code basically says something like this. Let's take this only 0 0 1 1 1 1 1 0 1 0. So basically, if we count the number of set bit at each position, here it is 1, here it's 2, here it's 1, here it's 2, here it's 1. So now if we see the code, let's take this together. Okay, so here I am forming this bit array. This would store this count f number of set bits on each of the corresponding ones, and this is storing the bit count. And then at the first operation, I am taking all these one from all the positions from which I can take. So like I can take 1 1 1 1 1, and this would now be transferred into, here I have taken 1, so it would be 0. Here I have taken 1, it would be 1, 0, 1, 1, then 0. So this would be something like this. I have taken this one number, which was initially the number which we discussed over here. Here it was. After transformation, by putting all these ones below, this was the number which we got. And here in the implementation from this array, I am just extracting all the ones, one set bits once, and reducing it from the count. So I'm iterating on this, and if it is not 0, then I'm taking this into the answer, and the value is 2 to the power I. So 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 4. So here it's adding, and then I'm reducing this to minus 1. And if I was not able to find any bit, that means in the next operation I would be getting 1, 1, and this array would be transforming into 0, 0, 0, 0, and 0. So in this operation I won't find any condition that bit is not equal to 0, that the current which I have to initialize as 0 will always remain 0, and we would be breaking because we have already covered it. And in the end I will adding this current into current, that is current square, to the answer and printing the answer. So this was the approach. This problem basically required deep observation that how the XOR and AND operation are basically changing the values. So here is the table. I think I was able to explain it. If you did not understood, please let me know. I will try to improve more. And if anything you want to ask, you can ask me below in the comment section. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching.